Let us understand the package which contains functions to manipulate the data. It is nothing but, so whatever I have mentioned with respect to JDBC, because I have specified JAS and driver class path here, it works fine here also. There won't be any issues. Let me just validate so that you get some confidence. So I'm running the same query here. You can see. Okay. Now let us go through the list of functions. So there is a package called PySpark.sql and then dot functions. And this actually contains a lot of predefined functions for manipulating the data. And those can be categorized under string manipulation, date manipulation, typecasting, expressions such as case, when, etc. And we will try to use some of the functions such as substring, lower, upper, trim, date format, trunk for demo purposes. So I'll be using both orders and order items data. To demonstrate these things, first let me go back here, okay, and let me copy from here till here so that we have orders and order items data for us to play with to understand all those APIs. So I have used spark.read.csv, read orders data into order CSV, and then typecasted order ID and order customer ID to integers. Same is the case with order items, okay? You can see order items.show and print schema here. All four fields, order item ID till quantity are integer, subtotal and product price are float type. Similarly, if you go to orders, order ID and customer ID are of type integers, and then order date is string and order status is string. Using this dataset, let us actually explore some of the APIs that are available. You can actually get help on all the APIs by saying from PySpark.sql, import functions, and then you can say help of functions and hit enter, and you can see all the functions that are available. Absolute, ACoS, I don't know what this ACoS is. Add months, if you want to add months to a date, you can use add months. And then approx count distinct, so if you just want to get approximate count on a particular field on distinct values, you can use approx count distinct. It will be faster, but it will not be 100% accurate. And then if you scroll further down, you have functions like average, so on and so forth. You can concatenate by saying concat. If you want to concatenate two fields or more than two fields, you can use concat function, and you can actually concat values from the columns. Okay. And then if you scroll down further, you have date format. So if you want to convert, or if you want to extract year from a date or month from a date, or if you want to change the format of the date while presenting to the front end, you can use this date format function. Okay, we will see a few examples so that you understand that. You can also use the date sub, date diff, date trunk to manipulate the data. We will be using these functions as we proceed further, and over a period of time you have to explore as many as you can. We will be only seeing few of those things so that you understand how these functions can be used. Okay, so I have defined few APIs here. One is substring. So for example, if you have orders and if you say show, it will actually show the 20 records with all the fields in our orders data frame. Let's say I want to extract these 7 characters, okay, which means I want to extract year and month. I can say orders dot select. So as part of the select, okay, so we have imported like this from PySpark.sql import functions. If I want to use substring, I have to say functions.substring. Instead of this, if I say PySpark.sql.functions import star, which means I'm importing everything from this PySpark.sql.functions. In that case, I can say orders.select, okay, and then substring, and I can pass the field name like this, order date, and I want to get only first 7 characters. So by saying 1, 7, I will be able to get first 7 characters. By saying show, I can see the data in the data frame. Okay, so whenever you issue any API on orders except show or some or action similar to show, such as collect, take, etc., everything else will actually return a data frame. To preview the data from the data frame, we can use show here. So orders.select will actually return a data frame, and by saying show, we are actually previewing the data. If you want to give the alias, you can do so by saying dot alias, and you can actually say the name of the field which you want to use as alias. Now we will get the field name as order month in this data. Okay, so this is how you can use substring. If you want to get the date also, then you can say 1, 10, and you should be able to get the date. You got the date part also. Now if you want to use orders, let's say I want to change the case of the order status, what I can do is I can say orders.select. Okay, there are APIs such as lower to convert your data into lower case, upper to convert data into your upper case, or init cap to keep the first character in each word in upper case and rest of the stuff in lower case, so on and so forth. There are multiple functions to manage the case of your data. So in this case, let's say I want to convert it into lower. So I can say order status like this. You can actually give alias, and I want to name it as order status only. Okay, and then hit enter. So in this case, it is not liking. If I pass column name like this, then what you have to do is you can specify the data frame name, which is orders, and then you can specify order status like this. Yeah, now it is working. And if you say show, it will actually get your order status in lowercase. Okay, if you want to get other fields while applying transformation on one of the field, instead of saying select, you can use this very important API called with column. Okay, so the difference between with column and select is select will only select the fields which you have mentioned as part of the select function. With column, it will actually return the data the way it was earlier. On top of it, it will also return this transformed data. Okay, and also you can say alias as the first argument to it, and then you don't need to specify alias like this when you use with column. With column itself takes two arguments. First will be alias, second will be the rule you want to apply to transform the data. Okay, now you will get order ID, order date, and order customer ID as is, and then order status will be written in lowercase. Okay, and then if you want to trim your data, if there are spaces in the beginning or end, and or if there is some other character, and if you want to trim that, you use trim function. Okay, so for that, I don't have any data which have spaces in the beginning or end, but what I can do is I can create a, let me see, I'm trying one thing here, it might work or it might not work. No, it is not working. Okay, anyway, I don't have example here. If you have a column with values where the leading or trailing characters has to be removed, then you can use trim. Typically, if there are spaces which you have to remove, you can use the function such as trim. And then date format, earlier we have used substring to get the year and month part of our date. We can also use date format. So I can say orders dot with column. Okay, I can specify order month like this, and then I can use date format orders dot order date. Okay, for some of the APIs, it takes the column names as string type, where you can actually pass something like this order date, and then let's say I want to get in this format YYYMM format. Okay, and then show. Some cases it will support both using string format like this. Okay, you can see here we got the year and month in YYYMM format. In some cases it might not have a function where the column names are can be passed as string type. If it fails the way it failed as part of lower, what you can do, taking the data frame name, which is nothing but orders in this case, you can actually pass the field name like this, and this also will work. Okay, if there is a function which you take the column as a string type, you can use in single quotes. If it fails for whatever reason, this approach should work. That is about date format. And then trunk. So trunk is again related to date. So let's say I want to get all the data from first of the month till today, then we use order date between trunk of this month using month as criteria till today, and you will get data based on that condition. And then we have already seen typecasting. Okay, so typecasting, you can see here we want to change order ID and order customer ID to integer type, and using with column we have already done this. Okay, so wherever you have to typecast your data to a particular type, first you need to import from types, from pyspark.sql.types, and then you have to apply that as part of the cast function on data frame dot the field name. Okay, that is about typecasting, which we have seen already, and hence I'm not going to show an example here.